Welcome everybody, this is your boy JC. Thanks for your tuning in for another unboxing. Well, it's pretty unboxed already, but you get the point. What I got before you today is just this wonderful internal SSD I got. It's a T-Force Cardo A440. I'll leave the link in the description. This is a pretty capable internal SSD that I got right here. I formatted it already, and the read speed I get is 6,557 megabits per second. Comes with a nice little copper writing right here. Well, what it actually does out of the box, it comes with this little paper or whatever you want to call it. You gotta place it on top of it right here, because out of the box it just comes with the chips shown out. So this little piece right here, you gotta slap it right over it. So this is what it looks like. Nice graphene, nice copper writing. It's very elegant looking internal SSD. This one in particular is a 1 terabyte internal SSD by T-Force, and it comes with a 5-year warranty. And also in the box, it comes with this amazing looking heat sink. It comes with a nice metal, I'll say some more aluminum, and these are the thermal pads it comes with. It comes with a very thin thermal pad. I wish it was a little bit thicker, but overall, it is what it is. It's very elegant looking, and one thing you can say for sure, this I can say I tested before I did this video, and with the internal SSD inside this heatsink, it will not fit inside the PlayStation 5. Well, actually, let me correct myself. It fits inside the PlayStation 5, but the plate would not close. It's just a little bit too tall. So it will fit inside perfectly. But it's just a little bit too tall, so the plate won't close properly. So you'd have to use your own heat sink that fits inside the PlayStation 5. The heat sink I have, which I usually use, oh, there it is, I was looking for it. This is my go-to right here. This is the iNeo heat sink. This is the copper. It comes with a nice grooves that will let the heat flow through easily. It's pretty cool. And I'll leave the link in the description. That's been my go-to for a while. There's several videos with several heat sinks that I use. And what I like to do after I do my upload test, I like to take it out and use my gun and test the temperature of the internal SSD and also the temperature of the heat sink. And the temperature is going to be in Celsius, not Fahrenheit. So as you can look, nice box right here. It's a beautiful presentation. It's a nice PCIe 4.0. It's the fourth gen internal SSD that's required for PlayStation 5. And as you can see in the box, the graphene aluminum. Talking about the heatsink right here. As you can see, it's a very elegant looking heatsink. And it's sure 1+1. In the box, it doesn't come with much. It doesn't come with a booklet. It just comes with a little casing for the heatsink and the internal SSD card. As we show in the back right here, it shows all little things right here, and it tells you the voltage and the operating temperature where it should get up to at least 70 degrees Celsius. And it shows right here the performance from the Crystal Disk Mark with the 1 terabyte and 2 terabyte variant. It should up the read and write speed is up to 7,000 megabits per second. But in reality, with every PlayStation, whether it be disc or whether it be digital, anytime you format internal SSD, it goes no higher. For my experience, it doesn't go no higher than at least 6,500 megabits per second. And this one goes to 6,557 megabits per second, which I think is all right. And it's good that this comes with a 5-year warranty. So if it breaks or malfunction within that time, you can always return it, get the exchange, or whatever they do. But it's good to have that in mind. So I'm not gonna bore you guys, because you guys probably see a whole lot of videos where people already install internal SSD on the heat sinks inside the PlayStation 5. So I'm not gonna go through all of that. What I'm gonna do, I'm just gonna go upload my games that I like to use to put it under some stress. And then what I'm gonna do, compare it with the same games, with the PlayStation 5 internal SSD to see which one uploads the fastest for these games I'm going to use. Alright, so I would like you guys to tune in to some more videos I'm going to be doing later on. And I like the presentation on this thing. It's very beautiful. As you can see, nice copper. I like it. It's very good looking. Now, can it compete with the PlayStation 5 internal storage? That's what we're going to find out right now. So keep back, relax, and enjoy this upload video. But before I do that, I'm going to have to pay some bills. So I'll be right back. All right, I'm about to do the upload speed test with the T-Force Carter A440. As you can see on the top left corner, and on the bottom left corner, that's the name of my channel. And on the bottom right, that's my timer right there. So I'm going to upload the God of War. I'm going to end when this child run across the screen. That's where I'm going to end it. All right. So it's going to begin in 3, 2, 1, go. Boom. So right there, I clock it at 52 seconds. That's not pretty bad, 52 seconds. Now, let me go out. I'm gonna go to the next one. It's gonna be Spider-Man Miles Morales. 3, 2, 1, go.
Spidey number 2.
32 seconds. All right. That's pretty cool. All right. Now we're going to reset the clock.
Why do you keep changing?
Go back out here. And I'm going to do the last but not least. The big boy. Red Dead. Red Dead Redemption 2 is a big game. It's 110 gigabytes. All right. I'm going to start it off. I'm going to start it off at 3, 2, 1. Let's go. Boom. 1 minute and 26 seconds. All right, that's pretty cool right there. So as you can see, for the previous games, all the times I have for the T-Force Carter. Now in the next video, I hope you guys tune in for the next video. I'm gonna do the upload speed test with the T-Force Carter
side by side the PlayStation 5 internal storage. Alright? Okay, let's conclude this video.
Alright, this is my favorite part of the video. We're gonna use my scanner and see what the temperature of the heat sink. And so roughly approximately 30 degrees Celsius. It's been in the PlayStation 5 for about 35 minutes. Cause that's why I usually keep it long in there before I do these tests. So it's 30 degrees Celsius. Let's see the temperature of the heatsink. I mean the internal SSD. Average of 35 degrees Celsius. Let me turn it around to the back and scan the back a bit, see what we get. And the back is even cooler, just like the heatsink. The heatsink was 30 degrees, the back is 30 degrees, and the front was like 35. Let's do the front one more time. You may get a little bit cooler afterwards. You guys could see. I like to do like 2-3 times to make sure. So roughly 30 degrees, that's not bad. And it feels pretty cool too. It feels pretty cool. So as you can see, let me just get it out of the way. Overall, I think this is a very speedy internal SSD. Is it worth the price? I think so. I would definitely go ahead and give this a try if you're interested. The T-Force Carter A440 Graphene 1TB. I think it's pretty good. As you show right here, comes with a 5-year warranty. And I personally like it. So you can always go on your Amazon or wherever you go, get your things. And you can pick up this nice little internal SSD right here. All right, this is the host JC. Thanks guys for tuning in for another video. And I would really appreciate it if you guys could like it up so you could get noticed inside the YouTube algorithm. Thank you, that's the best way you could support my channel other than subscribing. And you can look forward for the speed test comparison between this and the PlayStation 5 internal SSD. All right, ladies and gentlemen, thanks for watching and catch you in the next video. Peace out.